The number one hack that I'm gonna be sharing with you has saved my life. So many times I come into work, it seems like I've been dealing with hundreds of tasks. I go home and I feel like I haven't accomplished much. It seems like I've just been chasing my tail, haven't really been moving the needle, and it's just a really sucky feeling. This principle has helped me by categorizing my tasks based upon how important they are and how urgent they are, and in turn allowed me to actually focus on tasks that was able to move the needle. And I'm going to be sharing this task and this principle with you. How this works is basically in a four quadrant level. The top part is urgent and super important. Second quadrant is urgent but not important. Third is not important and not urgent. Lastly, it is important but not urgent. Now, when you have your tasks, you're going to be able to plot them into this grid. For example, if I were running a hair product company and we're in the middle of a new SKU that we're launching, some task that is super important would be communicating with our supplier to make sure that it comes in a timely manner, to make sure that it can hit our production time and that we get everything into a warehouse. That is something that is super important and super urgent, because if I do not communicate with them on a timely manner, then we're gonna miss our deadline, we're not gonna have anything to ship. So that is super timely and super urgent. Second thing that is urgent but not as important would be replying to customers' emails. It is super urgent because customer service is key in today's world when we're talking about e-commerce. But on the other hand, is it something that is gonna move the needle? Is it something that is super, super important? No, we're in the middle of a launch right now. So dealing with that would not be my priority, but it's something that is urgent because, like I said, customer service is very important. Third quadrant is not important and not urgent. For example, in this situation, I would not be planning my customer or Christmas outing because likely it's not important and is not urgent. We are at war right now, we're launching a new product, so this we can shove onto the side. A lot of times we end up doing tasks that are not urgent and not important because we're hiding and we're running away from tasks that's gonna be moving the needle and stuff that we don't wanna do. These are the frogs in the room that we do not wanna eat. And lastly, not urgent but important tasks. Okay, so we're talking about things that are not timely but super, super important as well. So something like forecasting for the new product, right? We haven't even sold the product. How can we do a forecast? Is that even important at this moment? No, but it's super important but just not urgent. Okay, so I definitely encourage you to download in the link below a template that we have actually set out, so then that way you can actually plot all your tasks into this template on a weekly basis and plan out your week, and you're going to be able to see that there are common themes that you're working on tasks on a regular basis that are not really moving the needle. So I encourage you to do that, and it's going to be able to save a lot of your time. The second tool that has saved my life is called myhours.com. This is a free website that allows you to be able to create different projects and different subtasks based upon the project that you're working on. What does not get measured does not get managed. And a lot of times our daily days and daily tasks are consumed by Facebook, by dealing with our friends, by dealing with the email. And I did not even know I was spending so much time dealing with emails until I was actually auditing the way that I'm spending my time on a daily basis. I actually kept a log of over 3 months of how I spend my time. And from there onwards, I was able to audit and actually bring to awareness on how I'm spending my time and be a lot more cautious about that. MyHours.com is a huge tool that has saved me and brought that into my awareness, which allowed me to take action to change and to rectify what I need to prioritize on. So make sure that you guys go on MyHours.com, start auditing the way you spend your time, and you're gonna be able to understand how you can save your time. The third tool that I'm gonna be sharing with you that's gonna save tons of your time is the Pomodoro technique. And what that is basically time blocking your time, being super hyper focused for the next 20 minutes to complete the task that you have. So many of us are being just bombarded by different noises around us. So for example, if we're working on a manual on the computer, we're bombarded by our friends, we're bombarded by emails, by different browsers, and a lot of times that soaks up a lot of our time because we're not focused, we're distracted by different things, we're multitasking, and in turn it takes hours for us to complete a document. So that's the reason why Pomodoro technique is so important and so effective, because you're hyper focused for 20 minutes, blocking out all the different distractions, working on that document of yours for 20 minutes straight, and then afterwards you can take a break and then go back to your next task. Sometimes your task might require 3 different sessions to complete, but at the end of the day, it is these short sprints that allow you to be much more productive in the task that you're doing, rather than dragging that whole duration out for hours to complete because you're distracted by different distractions, noises, and everything. In the resource below, I share with you the Pomodoro timer, so that way you can actually take action right away and actually start timing your tasks and actually time blocking it. So download it from the link below. I'm sharing it with you. Take action today and you're gonna save a lot of time. The fourth tool that I'm gonna be sharing with you is a project management tool. I personally love using Asana or Trello. Trello, these are two big players in the field of project management, and Asana allows you to basically put your whole business into this project management platform. And basically what it does is you can break your business down into different departments and you can assign it to the people that needs attention and be accounted for. So for example, in our business, we've broken it down into branding, marketing, logistics, finance, business development. Each of these big buckets, we have assigned it to different people who are in charge of it. And in turn, they're gonna be able to build up this bucket into different subtasks, allows you to be able to have different timelines, milestones, and which allows me to be able to have an oversight of what they're working on, and if they need any notes or it needs any comments, they're gonna be able to put it in there. This saves us a lot of time in between communication through email and not being able to stay in sync with what they're doing, because as a business owner, our job is to be able to visualize the business as a whole. And this project management tool allows us to see it as a whole and allows us to zoom in to different tasks based item that prevents us from having to talk to those people who are in charge of those tasks and going back and forth and trying to recalibrate where we are. I highly recommend, if you have a business, to put your business into a project management tool and start organizing it like that, because as your business grows, as your functions become a little bit more sophisticated and complicated, this allows you to have clarity in terms of how you manage your business and your projects. Download Asana and Trello. It is a free resource, definitely has saved a lot of my time through communication and getting me clarity on the projects. The fifth tool that is by far my favorite is Slack. Slack is a great communication tool that has saved me hundreds of hours. And why I'm saying that is because before using Slack, I was using email, I'm consumed with it on a daily basis, I'm getting hundreds of emails, and it's very difficult for me to be able to keep track because I'm running multiple businesses of which project it's for and which department it's for and what thread we're talking about. And that itself just drives me nuts when dealing with communication, which Slack solves. With Slack, you can actually categorize and actually have different channels for different businesses. Within each business, you can actually have different chat rooms specifically on the department that you're talking about. So for example, we have our Made in 9 project, and within that we have product development, we have general, we have logistics, we have finance, we have competitive analysis, and within each of these chat rooms we can talk about, hey, you know what, what is the MOQ for this unit? If it's 5,000, great, we can, now it's within this chat room. How much is it? Everything is within that chat room. We can ping whoever that we need to ping, and they basically, we have that communication there. We have files that we can put in, we have images that we can put in. That itself is able to categorize all the information within product development within that chat room. So in that way, I don't need to dig through hundreds of emails just trying to find that email thread on the MOQ and the prices. That itself is a godsend and has saved so much time dealing with organizing your email. So if you're not on Slack, if you're not on any kind of communication platform or tool, I highly recommend you download Slack. It's a free platform which has saved me hundreds of hours. Lifesaver. download it right now. So there you go, my top 5 life-changing tools that have saved me so much time, which gave back my life, which allows me to spend time with my friends, my family, and myself. The top 5 hacks and tools are Eisenhower principle, which allows you to categorize your tasks based upon how urgent they are and how important they are. Second tool is myhours.com. What doesn't get measured doesn't get managed. Measure your time, audit your time, see how you're spending your time, so then that way it brings to your awareness and you can start rectifying that. The third tool is the Pomodoro technique, basically time blocking, being super hyper focused on the tasks that you're working on so you don't get distracted amongst the millions of distractions out there on a daily basis. Number 4 is having project management tools such as Asana allows you to put your whole business on this platform that allows you to be able to see clearly what you're working on and how you're working on these tasks. And number 5, Slack, a great communication tool that allows you to communicate with your team within different projects, different channels, and that saves you tons of time not having to deal with emails. These are my 5 favorite tools. If you guys need any resources, download from the link below. I've compiled everything for you. This has been saving me so much time and energy and resources. So I really, really encourage you to download this link. It's just my gift for you. If you guys enjoy this video, leave me a thumbs up. If you guys want to be along this journey in building a successful e-commerce brand, definitely subscribe and follow along the journey. Otherwise, I'll see you guys in the next video.